This is probably the worst investment I've ever made in my life.
What's good?
So before we get into today's video, I want to give a shout out to the comment winners of the last video and the new subscribers. Now, I want to thank everybody who gave me the safe wishes of getting the new bike and telling me to be safe and be careful and those things are dangerous. I really want to thank you guys for caring about me. Now, on the other hand, that bike was probably the worst investment I've ever made in my life. Here's why. When I first bought the bike, I kind of figured that the bike would have some type of problems with it because of the price for it. I paid $1,200 for it. I'm a firm believer of you get what you pay for. My initial conversation with the guy, he told me it needed tires, new sprockets, and basic maintenance, i.e. oil change, spark plugs, coolant flush, and brakes. I didn't want to spend all that money on a brand new bike knowing that it's my first bike and anything can happen to it being that I'm a new rider. With that being said, I got in contact with a buddy of mine who knew a shop close by that could fix any problems on a bike that I had. So the initial plan was just take the bike to them and fix everything on it. Me being me, I wanted to look further into the bike just to be sure there was nothing else or any hidden problems with the bike. Let me tell you, I am so glad that I did that. Problem number one that I ran into was this thing called the sprocket cover. A bike has two sprockets on it, one in the rear and one in the front. In order to get to the one in the front, you have to take off this thing called the sprocket covers. It's legit a cover, it covers up the front sprocket from any debris. So I go to take off the sprocket cover and what do I find out? At the bottom of the sprocket cover, where one of the bolts is, the thing is completely broken off and cracked in half. That means it is no good. The reason being is because right at the bottom, it's a spring that holds on to the bottom of that bolt that going to conglomerate with the clutch. Without that piece, the clutch is not gonna work. So I decided I can fix my own bike. I don't need to spend $200, $300 for somebody else to put on a sprocket when literally it's just 5 bolts on the back of the rear drum to take the sprocket off and then putting that same 5 bolts back on the rear drum with the new sprocket. Well, this is where I run into the problem number two. As I'm putting the bolts back on the rear drum on the back wheel, the nuts on the rear drum start to get stripped. That means you get to a point where the bolt's supposed to lock and it's not supposed to turn anymore. No, these kept turning and turning and turning and turning. I didn't know why. I take a closer look and the axles on the rear drum are stripped themselves. At this point, I'm ripping my hair out. Well, not my hair up here, but more likely my mustache. You know what? Honestly, I think I'm so in over my head with this bike, I'm just gonna get rid of it. I'm not even gonna waste my time with it. I've already called a junkyard. They're willing to give me $100 for it. I'm getting rid of it. Bottom line.
I'm just kidding.
I actually went on eBay recently and found the same exact sprocket cover for about $54 and then turned around and got a rear drum in great condition, by the way, for like $76. So I decided to go ahead and throw those on. I was gonna record it and walk you guys through it, but I figured you guys wouldn't be interested in that. So I just put these little quick clips in of me throwing it on there. Now, most of you guys are probably thinking,
why did you buy a bike that you had to put all this work into?
Well, one, I wanted something that I could build myself and actually learn how to work on bikes. Like I said in the beginning, I don't want a brand new bike knowing that I will possibly, God knock on wood, that I will not drop this bike, but thinking realistically, that could happen. And I don't want it to be a brand new 2019, 2020. Just thinking logically, that makes no sense. Two, I come from a family who's very mechanically savvy. My dad, my granddad, my grandma, my uncles, and my cousins all know how to work on cars, including myself. I didn't go to school to work on cars or motorcycle. I am self-taught. So if I get a situation with my car or my motorcycle, I can fix it myself. I don't have to go to a dealership and spend hundreds of dollars for a spark plug that I can do myself. And three, this is not my main source of transportation. This is a toy, this is a hobby. I'm not dumping every penny that I have into this bike. If I have the money to put in the bike, then I'll do it. But I'm gonna make sure everything else is set first. Like, my main source of transportation is okay before the bike. And this guy just rode by on his motorcycle, kinda just like in my face that he'd get to ride his bike and I can't. Oh, also, I cannot forget, I have brand new Stu stickers back in stock. So if you want some, hit my jack, hit all my social media platforms, and I'll send some directly to you. The summer is right around the corner, and I want the Stu Nation rocking all the best Stu merch as possible. And the second thing is, I want you guys to have a better understanding of my post schedule. Mondays and Wednesdays are my main post days for regular vlogs like these. Anything from daily vlogs to pranks is probably gonna be on Mondays and Wednesdays. Now, for the new segment, the GoPro Sunday Ride Series, obviously those are always gonna be posted on Sunday. By the way, thank you for all the love that I get from those videos. I got a lot of great responses from people on my Instagram and on the last couple videos that I posted for those. But I just wanna give you guys a video and keep you guys in the loop and updated on my plans and what's to come and what problems I've ran into so far. Other than that, I just want to thank you guys for all the support and love that you guys give me on all the videos that I drop. Thank you, Stu Nation. Till next time, your boy Stu